proof?
Turn around. Today. Well, am I? Yeah, 4 more miles to go to this easy 10 miles. Today, what am I thinking of today? I don't even know. Except, I breathe into the body as usual, which I'm amazed. I could be wrong, but I used to hear all these things about running is bad for your joints. But the last couple of years, you know, I've had a little setback in running, and I run like every 10 days or 15 days, just a quick 50 miles. And so I went back to running again every day, you know, still doing the same thing, the yoga, the meditation. And I started to realize that doing yoga every day before and after a run, that's what I should have been doing for years. You know, I've always practiced yoga, but not like the way I've done the last 6 to 7 years or so. And I mean every day. So, like, literally practicing yoga 365 days a year, it is a different ball game. And you begin to pay attention to your body too. Yeah. You realize, just like these trees right here, and how they're gonna turn green very soon in the next couple of months. Yeah, that's the same way your body is. But you gotta be very patient with it. Yeah. Because the more you stretch it, it will just stretch like an inch. You won't believe it. Yeah. Morning. You will not believe it. Your body will just stretch an inch the more you do it. It's amazing. So, and doing stretching every day and doing all that, I've come to realize that my body is actually designed to run every day. I can run it. I run every day. You know, just at a slow pace. It's like an easy job. And the whole thing now, the movement turned into meditation. You know, so I'm not really running. I'm just meditating and watching the way I put my feet down. And, you know, I got to breathe in all this oxygen into my head. I see nature every day. I'm outside every day, literally. There's another day. Today, the 29th or the 38th. So I've been out every day this month already. You know, so there's not a day that I don't see the sky. I know when the stars are out. Like, you don't see a lot of them today. You know, I know when the moon. When the moon is, I don't know what percentage it is right now. But I see every single day. You know, and it's funny how most people don't even know what the moon looks like. You know, I wouldn't say don't know, but they don't even know when it comes out. Most people don't even know when it's full. Because sometimes our daily activities, you know, stress can really make us not pay attention to that thing. And boy, oh boy, if that moon stops shining, we are in a lot of trouble. Because that's how you eat your food. And the sun, if that sun starts shining, that's how your food comes about. That literally, we are nothing without those things, the sun and the moon. But yeah, we barely go out and say thank you to it. Yeah. So it's really funny. And the earth, we just do whatever the monkey we want to it. But these are the things that give us that food that we put in our mouth. We're so ignorant to it, it's amazing. You know, it's almost like, oh, what about this thing that gives you food? You know, the gravity that make us pull. You know, because those things don't have a name. You know, because it doesn't matter where you are, gravity is pulling you somewhere. We never even thought about those like that. So, staying outside all the time, as you can see, I have to put my hand in my pocket. I got gloves on and it's still mother biscuit cold. So staying outside all the time, I see things differently. You know, it allows me to deal with my emotions, like I always talk. So today I don't even know what I'm thinking. You know, what ideologies come into my head. But I just know nature's one of them today. So I'm talking about it. You just rumble to myself. Look at the trees and everywhere is quiet right now. You don't see anything outside. Just look at the trees and you got people going to work. You know, some are still sleepy and it's just amazing. You know, then you got some of us who's gonna go to work later. You know, but how do you start your day? You know, for me, this is the way I start my day. I've done it for years, you know. I've done it for actually over 15, 16 years, you know. Getting up very early, extremely early, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the morning. That's the time that I've get up for years. You know, so I don't even know what it feels like to be in bed at 7 a.m. It's just, you know, or getting up at 5 a.m. or even 6 a.m. It just does something to my body. Even when I go out somewhere, I would rather get up that early than go back to bed. You know, I call it my nap time. So it's really amazing, you know, how an habit can be formed. So this whole running, jogging every day, it's not even running anymore. You know, I just come out here and just move my feet. You know, so that's just what it is, you know, so. It's a place, it's a space of just being me. You know, I've done it for many, many years. I was quite shy about it, actually. It's only recently that I begin to just kind of talk about it, put it more on the social media. You know, so this is not a new behavior. You know, it's just, now I can, you know, could just run my mouth. This is not a new way of life. It's just something that I've done many, many years. Many, many years, you know. After 10,000 hours, this thing is not a run anymore. It's just a part of real life. It's a way of life. You know, something that I've done for years. So today, nature is one of my things today. Nature, yes, that's it. How this thing supplies us food, the air that we're breathing. You know, how in a couple of months, I would not be dressing like this. It just blew me. It's mind-blowing. Can you believe that? Well, let me just cross the road right here. Is there a car coming? Nah, I could just stroll. I would not be dressing like this in a couple of months. Now that's amazes me. In a couple of months, I will not be dressing like this. I can literally put on a t-shirt. That is just, now to me, that's just, I don't know what to call it. So, nature is what I'm focusing on. You know, man, the moon is not even out. Where is it? Where is it? I can't even see it yet. It's probably hiding somewhere. I'm actually trying to look for it. So, that's what I'm going to focus on today. And how that thing has sustained me. You know, the sun, what it does to my skin. I mean, would you believe that? When a baby is born and they do not use the bathroom for like 10 days after they've been born. I literally tried it when my son was born. When you go outside and put that baby outside in the sun, that baby will have a bowel movement. Ah, amazing. My son did not have a bowel movement for 14 days. And I don't know where I heard it from or what book I was reading. Took him outside, put him underneath the sun. I kid you not, he had a bowel movement that day. So it just amazed me how we don't even look at the sun. Take a look at the moon sometimes. Or that little sun in the morning and close your eyes. It is so amazing, that little red thing that you see that forms when you close your eyes while you're looking at the sun. Little things like that. You know? So it's almost like everything in our body can heal itself. Except for which way? Is it the feet? Yeah, everything in your body. Eyesight. You know, like when I remember, I go and look at the moon and just close my eyes. I like seeing that red thing. So today, if you will, pay attention to nature. That thing that sustains us. It's about to get warm pretty soon. And all the grasses and trees are going to start changing. Pay attention this today. And that's why I like standing still every morning, because, and coming out here, actually I have something to think about, because every time I put my foot out here I realize I know biscuit, I know nothing. So let me go ahead, finish up this easy 10 mile jog, but pay attention to nature today. Until tomorrow, man, by this time, this, I think this month, I think I'm going to end up with 400 or something miles. Yeah, I already passed 400. 440 or something like that. So, until tomorrow, breathe into the body.